these billion-dollar company founders, these celebrities are real people that have their own challenges, their own struggles, their own learnings, and it is possible.
Good morning, good morning. This is Jeff Fu, halfway around the world in Phuket, Thailand, for Archives Global Summit. I have some of the best engineers and AI researchers building the next-gen social commerce platform, meaning that we're building software automation, software infrastructure, and gen AI tools to help brands grow more quickly. We're backed by over $12 million from some of the best VCs in the world and generate millions in ARR. So we're gonna learn today, what's it like running a hyper-growth software company in 2023? Let's go. All right, my sparring partner this week, how's it going, Mustafa?
It's going well. You know, it's been great hanging out this past few days, spending some time with the team. Lots of fun, but yeah. Lots of work.
You're one of our founding AEs, helping set up the account executive motion for us. Love to get your sense of that challenge and how's it going so far.
You know, my role as an AE and then an entire sales team is essentially to talk to brands and then make the use case. And so at the end of the day, our goal is like, we have a solid product. We have really product market fit. How do we bridge the gap? So it's like the product is here, the brands are out there, increase awareness and get people to understand the impact that Archive can have. We're a company that's all about metrics. It's all about numbers. You know, there is no fluff. It's like, hey, we talk, here's the product, but then exactly here's what you get out of it, right? So, you know, if you have some assets, you're working with your social, you have community, how do you put that in terms of specific metrics? Like, how do you repurpose it? How do you use it so that it actually drives impact for you?
Yeah, I mean, I know we're scaling up on AEs and BDRs, SDRs now. I know that you've been a part of a number of just well-organized sales teams. What are attributes that we should be looking for, that you'll be looking for folks on the sales side that will be joining?
You know, on the sales side, obviously ambition is important. Like, you can't do without ambition, right? It's important for you to have your personal goals, and then you have your company or professional goals, both for yourself and for the team. What that brings is really deep, solid resilience, right? So you're gonna hit roadblocks, you're gonna run into challenges. You know, if the product is popular, people will be calling you, you'll be calling people. And, you know, there's going to be that back and forth, but I think it's that, and it's part of our company culture as well here to make sure that, you know, we are resilient, we work hard. It's a fast-paced, high-performing team, and, you know, we talk about efficiency. So all of those things are very important, but, you know, earlier you were talking about integrity, right? So you have a certain level of values for yourself. It's like, here are my values. Here are the things I want to live up to. And so integrity basically is you feel more integrated if your behavior is matching with that level of values that you're setting for yourself.
I mean, even in the few months that you've been ramping up here, I know you've just added six figures in ARR already. So yeah. Continue crushing.
Thank you. Yeah, I appreciate it, Jeff.
People is the most important attribute and asset for a company. So you run recruiting for us. So that means you essentially touch every single person that we interview, that goes through our pipeline, goes through our funnel. Previously, you were working at Amazon AWS. I want to just get a sense, like the talent bar that you're seeing that you were working on at Amazon and AWS versus what you're seeing at Archive.
Yeah, I would tell you, like, in our case, and I speak to a lot of candidates, and we are a startup, and a lot of candidates like, oh, your recruitment process is very long. We need to do the technical exercise. We need to do the technical interview. You have a virtual on site. Like, you're doing the same as the biggest companies does, like Google, Amazon, etc. And many times they ask me, why do you do that? Isn't two interviews enough? And what I try to explain them is we do such a long process because our hiring bar is very high. And since we're looking for A players, and A player is very hard to find, this is why having this process allow us to actually understand who is an A player and who can come into Archive and actually deliver. So this is why that's important. But yeah, our talent bar, I would tell you, it's probably higher than Amazon's at this point of time.
I would like to hear that, but I think that is the case. I know just from even, you know, when I'm a hiring manager from some of these roles, I am phone screening a lot of different people. So I'm just kind of curious in terms of your experience being first line of, you know, on the front lines talking to candidates.
Yeah.
How many people are we emailing? How many people are we calling every single month?
So I can tell you, but for the last 6 months, we emailed 1,800 and something people, and across different roles, we did 247 interviews. And out of those all interviews, only 9 offers came out. So to have an idea, for us to have one offer extended, we need to do at least 27 interviews with potentially good candidates that work in a really good companies that have a really good career path for us to hire one person. It's crazy.
Yeah, I like how you actually have the metrics. So essentially our offer rate is around 50 basis points.
Yeah.
So 0.5% offer rate out of Archive. We are not just emailing anyone off the street. We are emailing top people. So basically for the best of the best, you're emailing and then through our funnel.
Exactly.
And so yeah, I mean, hopefully that process really does distill out truly A players. Because one thing that, you know, as I have invested over 60 companies, I see a lot of companies operate. I think a lot of young founders don't actually understand what A players actually look like.
Yeah.
I think they're just like, oh, I think I work pretty hard and they work pretty hard. I think I'm an A player. So okay, yeah. He works just as hard as me. They're an A player. And it's not enough. You have to really benchmark with people that are the best in class in the world, right? Like track records of working at the Amazons, working at the Googles, or winning science fairs, or winning math competitions, or winning programming competitions. Any patterns that you've seen in terms of like technical backgrounds or competition background that you see is particularly high signal for candidates?
Yeah, so if we speak about the technical candidates, for example, software engineers, candidates who participated in different Olympiads, who had Olympiads in school, in the university, who went actually outside to try to win something, typically those have a really high technical background. But I would say not only that is important, because for us, when we do the interviews, we also focus in our standards, for example, Archive standards. And one of the important standards for us is actually curiosity to understand what the people do outside their job, right? So they do not only code all day, but they actually go outside, they learn something new, they see what is new on the market, and then they actually bring it to the company. And those people typically have the very high percentage rate of being an A player.
Yeah, I think that's well said. So we talk a lot about being an AI-first company. And I think when we talk about it, we don't just bullshit and talk about it, we're really being about it. We implement all the latest AI tools in our workflows, implementing the most advanced open source algorithms into our products. I mean, I think one of the big technology stack companies, like a multi-billion dollar infrastructure company, wants us to be a marketing partner because we're doing some of the most interesting innovations on their cloud AI infrastructure. What are some highlights that you are especially impressed about or excited about in terms of using AI in our development process and or implementing AI to offer consumer and customer applications?
I guess it probably would be important to mention that we started thinking about AI early on, right? Like when all of these technologies were still very non-mature, like non-existent, we started investing time into research, into understanding how it works, so that when the time comes, we are ready.
Yeah.
And when the time comes, we were ready. So we started immediately working on implementing this into our application, right? And I guess, again, a lot of the people on our team are excited about all of the like ChatGPT, all of the power of AI into their daily tasks. But what we're focusing on now is trying to build this into like general teams workflow.
Yep.
To like remove some of the like cumbersome tasks and just like replace them with AI. So I guess this will be focused for us for the rest of the year to find the applications. We already have some ideas. We just need to make them work, integrate them into like our CI/CD process. And I think this will be a big step because as we know, there is a lot of stuff, like a lot of boilerplate, a lot of like manuals that were like writing tests, specs, everything that can be automated.
Yeah, no, I'm really excited about it. I mean, this is like the computer science nerd in me where all the DevOps and ML ops related to the best workflows and processes in which to develop ML and machine learning is still being defined. And I think we might have a chance to really open source some of these ideas and get credit as industry thought leaders, right? Like that's my hope. I think we're very advanced in applying these technologies in production, where I think most people are myth-building toys. Like we're dealing with massive, massive data sets. I think we're just seeing, Evgeny was showing kind of the amount of data we were processing. It's large.
Yeah, it's impressive, yeah.
Especially thinking about how it all started, right?
Yeah.
And where we are at now, so yeah, it's pretty impressive.
Cool. Yeah, lots to build, so let's keep building. Yeah. AI is such a transformational way in which humans interact with computing. We're just in the early innings of what that truly means.
So I think keeping our eye off the ball is premature. One, slowly understanding the implications of how AI, Gen AI, large language models, neural networks will impact all forms of computing, all forms of human interaction with computing is still being defined. And I think the second part, which I think may be a little bit forward-looking, is how do we apply that technology in a way that's useful for people? It's more of like the human application side of the AI foundations. Most of that work is yet to be done. And I think multiple billion-dollar companies will be built figuring out applications and figuring out ways to deploy AI applications better to people.
All right, we gotta head to the airport. Got a big flight to catch. We gotta get some real work done back in the States. We'll see you next time.